الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين، سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تعالى في القرآن الكريم بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. وقال عيدا: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصل عليه. All praise, all reverence, all majesty is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the creator, who is the sustainer, who is the nourisher of all the worlds. Peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be constantly showered upon the pride of mankind, the intercessor of sinners, the rising star of Medina, Huzur Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was sent into this earth as rahmatul alameen, mercy upon the entire of creation. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his many boons and many favors that he has bestowed upon us. More so, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for being able to assemble on this blessed day of Sayyid al-Ayyam, the blessed day of Jum'ah, in this blessed month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our efforts and all our a'mal in this month. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this month a source of us getting His closeness. So often the month of Ramadan has dawned upon our lives and it has left our lives. But the question still lies void in our hearts. What is Ramadan? What is this month of Ramadan? Year in and year out, it has become a ritual and has become mere routine for us. And we forget that this is the blessed month. Inshallah, today very shortly we would like to discuss about what is Ramadan and the essence of this blessed month of Ramadan. Firstly, we like to take the word Ramadan. The word Ramadan, and we would like to give it a linguistic meaning. Ramadan is taken from the word Ramad. In the Arabic language, Ramad means to feel a scorching pain in the stomach due to the pangs of hunger. And it is a very known fact that this month is associated with hunger and this month is associated with thirst. So now the question arises, is that why? What does this hunger, what does this thirst bring towards us? Because everything, there's a maqsad, there's a reason for it. Sometimes we may not understand the reason, sometimes we may understand the reason, but everything in creation is created by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to work simultaneously with each another. So what does this hunger, or what does this scorching pain due to the pangs of hunger bring to a human being? And how does this bring him close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? To answer this question, we need to go back. We need to go back to a place where time did not exist, where place did not exist. This is when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had created and He had molded and He had fashioned the shape of man into what he is today, which is you and I. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He took the sun and He fashioned Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, our father. And then when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He blew the ruh into Adam alayhi salam, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created something. He created something to put into the soul, to put into the body of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam, and this was the nafs. The nafs is what me and you, we can translate to be the cardinal desires, the animalistic part of the human body. So now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created this nafs, something very interesting happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He questioned the nafs. And He says, O nafs, who are you and who am I? And this very instinct or this cannibalistic nature which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created, it replied to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala arrogantly.
And what did it say? It said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am I and you are you. Imagine this. Imagine this. In the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it says to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I am I and you are you. Upon hearing this response, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala became angry. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commanded the malaika, take this disobedient servant of mine and put him into the fire of Jahannam. And he was subjected, the nafs was subjected to the fire of Jahannam for 1,000 years. After 1,000 years of being punished, it was returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When this nafs returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again Allah poses the question, O nafs, who are you and who am I? And again arrogantly it replied, it said, I am who I am and you are who you are. For the second time, it not only disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it was disrespectful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And upon this, Allah became angry. And what did Allah do? He says, O my malaika, O my angels, take this disobedient servant of mine and place him into the fire of Jahannam for 1,000 years. And again, the malaika, they took the nafs. They took this cardinal desire of man and it placed it in the fire of Jahannam for 1,000 years. And again, it returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah poses the question again, O nafs, who are you and who am I? And again it replies to Allah, I am who I am and you are who you are. Then upon this Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does something amazing. He inflicts a punishment upon this nafs, not like any ordinary punishment. At first Allah had put it into the blazing fire. It did not affect it. It was hurt, it was destroyed. But yet still, its arrogance remained. So now what Allah did? Allah said, O my malaika, O my angels, take this nafs, but this time do not place it into the fire. Place it into the valley of hunger. For 1,000 years it was placed into the valley of hunger. It was deprived of food. It was deprived of drink. It was deprived of all its necessities. But Allah, because of the will of Allah, it remained alive. So now what happened? When Allah commanded that the nafs return, it was dragging itself upon the floor. It was weak, it could not even stand properly. And when it returned to Allah, Allah poses the question again. He says, O nafs, O you cardinal desires, who are you and who am I? And this time, for fear that Allah would put it back into such a state where it would be weak and it would be deprived of all its sustenance, it replied, Ya Allah, I am the nafs and you are Allah, you are my Lord. So now let us understand that this nafs, this cardinal desire is in each and every one of us. From the time of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam till the last person, this nafs is placed into the body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave us this blessed month of Ramadan so that we can subject our cardinal desires to the hunger, to feel the hunger, so that when it is put under hunger, then it could be controlled. A simple example can be drawn. Most of us, we have animals at home, or most of us, we have visited the zoos. When an animal is to be trained, what happens? What does the trainer do? What he does is that he gives it food the first time and he leaves it. Then what he does, he gives it food but in little quantities. And the animal must work for that. And eventually to train it and to tame it properly, he does not give it food for a little while. And eventually that animal becomes tamed. Similarly, each and every one of us, there's that animal inside of us. There is that animal inside of us. And the sad fact is that most of us, we think that the reason that we are doing actions which are displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is because of the waswasa of shaitan. It is not because only of the waswasa of shaitan. Because if we look at ourselves, what does the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say? إِذَا جَاءَتِ الرَّمَضَانِ that when the month of Ramadan approaches, futihat abwabul jannah, that the doors of Jannah open, وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ, and the gates of hell are closed, وَسُفِرَتِ الشَّيَاطِينَ, and the shaitan, and the shayateen, that they are chained. So now the question is, why is it that in the month of Ramadan, we are continuously doing these bad actions? It is not only because of shaitan and the waswasa and the whisperings of shaitan, but it's also because of this influence of this animal that we have inside of us. This animal that for 11 months of the year, we let the shaitan and the waswasa, and we let our emotions free. Then when the month of Ramadan approaches us, then we would want to say, but why is it I can't attain the closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The greatest enemy of a person lies within himself. That is why when he stands in the courts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question him, Ya Fulan, O servant, why is it that you did this action? Why is it that you did so and so action? And he will reply to Allah, Oh Allah, this is because of shaitan. Then what would shaitan say? Shaitan would say, Ya Allah, I did not hold his hands and force him to do his actions. All I did was whisper into his ear. And that beast inside of him took control of his body. So let us understand that the greatest enemy of a man, it is himself and it is this nafs. And it is because of this, we can attain two parts. We can attain two things. If we learn to control it properly and make it obedient, like how the proper people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like how the awliya-i kiram, how the anbiya-i kiram, they control themselves. They become in such a maqam that they are even superior than the malaika of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who are ma'asum creation. But if we let this inner self and these cardinal desires take control of ourselves, then we become worse than even the animals that are walking. And we look for ourselves. What is the state of the ummah today? We look for ourselves. What is going on? Ramadan comes and it goes. But it is just mere practices. We come to the masjid, we fast all day. We come to the masjid, we read our salah. But there is no benefit in this month. We read the Quran 3, 4, 5 times. But there is no result. Why? Because this month of Ramadan, and this is the true essence of the month of Ramadan, it isn't to deprive yourself of food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need your food. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need that drink. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need you to stay away from your spouses. But this month of Ramadan is to teach us, and it is training, and this is tarbiyah, that we may control that beast inside of us. And when we learn to control that beast inside of us, then we have control of our entire bodies. And slowly by slowly, we must work towards this. It isn't only about saying that we are fasting, we're staying away from food, we are staying away from drink. No. It is about to train the body. It is about to train the heart. It is about to train everything in the human body, including and especially that nafs, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when that nafs becomes obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then and only then we attain that true closeness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the month. This is the month where we try our best. The waswasa of shaitan is not there. Now we must focus on ourselves. Allah gave us 11 months of the year to block out the shaitan. 1 month to focus on ourselves. Let us focus on ourselves. And this is not any ordinary month. As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam goes, which is narrated by Hazrat Salman al-Farsi, he says, قَالَ خَتَبَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam فِي آخْرِ يَوْمِ الشَّعْبَانِ, that on the last day of Sha'ban, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood and he gave lecture, he gave a khutbah. فَقَالَ, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O people, and listen to the wording. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't say ya ayyuhal mu'minun. He said ya ayyuhan nas, that this is a general advice. Qad adallakum shahran mubarakan aziman fihi laylatun khayru min alfi shahr, that upon you has dawned a month which is blessed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is a blessed month, which is a great month. And within this month, that that there is a night, that this night is greater than 1,000 months of worship. And the Prophet ﷺ continues and he tells us about this month of Ramadan. جَعَلَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He had made the fasting faridatan, He had made the fasting farad upon you. وَقِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ تَتَوُّعًا, and He has made the standing in the night, the Taraweeh prayer, sunnat upon you. That this is the month of Ramadan, that during the night, we stand and we sacrifice our sleep for to stand and for the Taraweeh Salah. That during the day, we sacrifice food. And it is a sad fact that when we look around today, that people complain. People complain that Islam is such a religion that it depends your food. Islam is such a religion that it makes you not drink for the whole day. And we complain of our lives, that how hard our lives is. But let's go back and look at the lives of the Sahaba-e-Kiram. Look at the lives of the Sahaba-e-Kiram. That when they were fasting, in that state of fasting, that they would go for battles. In that state of fasting, they would increase in their work. In that state of fasting, they would do more actions. But ourselves, what are we doing? What are we doing? Today we say that the fast is hard, but 3/4 of the day we are sleeping. 3/4 of the day we are sitting and we say we can't do this work. We're going to leave the work for outside of Ramadan. We look at the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. During the month of Ramadan, he would do more work than any other month of the year. We call ourselves ummatis, but seriously, what are we doing? It is a time, the month has now begun, alhamdulillah. We have whole month ahead of us. Let us set our mindset in such a way that we embrace the month of Ramadan. That we understand the true value of this month of Ramadan. Only when we understand its value, only when we understand what is this month of Ramadan, then we can make steps and we can make plans to attain the closest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Such a month, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَمَنْ تَقَرَّ بِخَسْرَةٍ, that the person who intends to draw close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing a nafil action, what is his reward? His reward is that he has done the action of fard. فِيمَا سِوَاهُ, in any other time of the year. And the person who does the action, the fard action, what is his reward? As the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that the person who does one fard action, he gets the reward of 70 fara'id in this month. My dear respected brothers and sisters, let us understand that this is not a normal month, that this is not an ordinary month, but this is indeed a blessed month. That upon us, we are lucky that we have life. We look back, how many of our brothers from last year did not make it to see this month? How many of us are sure that we're going to see another Ramadan in our lives? Let us utilize this month to the best of our ability so that we can attain the closest of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last point I would like to bring towards you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, أَوَّلُهُ رَحْمَةً, that the first 10 days of this month brings the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَوْسَتُهُ مَغْفِرَةً, and the second 10 days of this month brings the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَآخِرُ, and the last portion of this month, إِتْقُمْ مِنَ النَّارِ, brings the emancipation from the fire of Jahannam. We are in the first 10 days. Let us raise our hands. Let us raise our hands and let us lower our heads. And let us make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we attain His rahmah in this month. In the first 10 days, let us be of those fortunate people who attain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the first 10 days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those people who attain His forgiveness in the second 10 days. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those people who attain the emancipation from the fire of Jahannam in the last 10 days. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all of our actions in this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts to the understanding that upon us has dawned a great month. Let it not go by as the previous years had gone by, except that we had gained something from this month. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ الْمُبِينَ
لِهِ وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ وَأُمَّتِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ اللهم ربنا اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولأساتذتنا ولمشايخنا ولأقربائنا ولمن له حق علينا ولجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات بحرمة اسمك واسم حبيبك وبحرمة كلامك يا الله. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.
طلع البدر علينا من ثنيات الوداع وجب الشكر علينا ما دعا لله داعي. يا حبيبي يا محمد يا نبي سلام عليك، يا رسول سلام عليك، يا حبيب سلام عليك، صلوات الله عليك. مجھے در پہ پھر بلانا مدنی مدینے والے، مہِ عشق بھی پلانا مدنی مدینے والے. میرے سب عزیز جھوٹے، سب یار بھی تو روٹے، کہیں تم نہ روٹ جانا مدنی مدینے والے. یا حبیبی یا محمد یا نبی سلام علیکا، یا رسول سلام علیکا، یا حبیب سلام علیکا، صلوات اللہ علیکا. تیری عرش پر حکومت، تیری فرش پر حکومت، تو شہنشاہ زمانہ مدنی مدینے والے. میری آنے والی نسلیں تیرے عشق میں ہی مچھلے، انہیں نیک تم بنانا مدنی مدینے والے. یا حبیبی یا محمد یا نبی سلام علیکا، یا رسول سلام علیکا، یا حبیب سلام علیکا، صلوات اللہ.
ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا انك انت التواب الرحيم. بعظمة سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك.
کتنا حسین و دل ربا دارو،